with Ian Nuhn of Nuhn Industries, and we're going to look at the lagoon crawler. So this actually starts out on dry land and walks its way or rolls its way down into the lagoon. Tell me how it works.
Yeah, we've got a four-wheel drive hydrostatic planetaries on each drive wheel, same out of like a mini excavator, like proven rugged drive motors. So it's all remote control. The operator, you can lift this thing up. It's got about 4.5-5 feet of ground clearance. And basically they can drive right off the trailer, drive right into the lagoon. The whole thing floats with these flotation pontoons. And then once it's in the lagoon, you know, depending on the thickness and how much solids is in there, you know, they can bring the wheels up and maneuver around with the jets. Or if it is quite thick, then they can use the drive wheels to kind of give it some assistance.
So you have a large pump in the middle that basically pulls the liquid in and then distributes it amongst all these jets. And
exactly.
Using those jets, you maneuver yourself around.
Exactly, yeah. We've got one of our, it's actually patented header technology. We've got four discharges on our pump. Like this is a 275 horsepower engine. That pump is so efficient, we're only using 200 horsepower. Mm-hmm. And it's doing over 10,000 gallons a minute through the system. So when you take that volume and you translate it to that pond there, you can agitate it very fast and very efficiently and very, and like when I say efficiently, it's actually like 6.5 gallons an hour of diesel consumption.
Really? So all the agitating and all the maneuvering all comes from that central pump?
That central pump is the main system for all of the jets here, yeah.
Okay. How much does this thing weigh?
It's 13,500 empty and then 15 with fluids. It's really easy to use. Like this whole tube piping system is all pressurized from that main high volume pump. There's a computer on board, so when you hit left on that control panel, it automatically opens the diagonal valve so that it can rotate in the spot. We've also got a nice feature where if you hit shift left, for instance, it opens the valves on the side, on the same side, so you can shift it, you know,
just
left or right.
Skid over to
so
the
if you're trying to get out and your boat's lined up with a bank, you can just side shift it to get to the driveway out. So
now it crawls in the lagoon, does it crawl out of the lagoon?
Most of the time, yes. If it's got a concrete ramp or if it's like a relatively dry ramp, no issues. This thing's got a ton of torque, 7,000 newton meters per drive wheel of torque to pull out. So it's got a ton of torque. It's just mainly traction. After, if it's kind of a wet, like soft, like mud, then it's it really doesn't need much to boost it out. We were at a pit in California, and there's nothing around except our little Chevy Impala rental car. So we wrapped a chain around the back axle, and that's all it needed was just a little tug to pull it out.
So can you, is this mostly to agitate, or can you actually connect a line and go straight to the field with
it? Yeah, we are hooking up, guys are hooking hoses to these.
Where would they hook it?
We make a different front U channel in this front section here. Basically, there's an 8-inch discharge valve.
Uh-huh.
So, you know, guys, if they're tanking, they can have a stationary load stand. Put this out in the middle, fill tanks, not quite at 10,000, maybe around the 8 or 9 mark. And then some guys, for drag, they'll use this for their main booster.
So, okay, and then they'll pump it up to it to a pump and then take it out the field.
So some guys, you know, they might be pushing 200 feet, and I've got another guy, he's pushing about 1.25 miles to the main booster. So about that distance, he's really only getting about 1,500 gallon a minute at the other end. So
then you can put another pump on there.
Yeah, keep going from boosters from there.
Well, tell me a little bit about the mechanism that raises those tires out of the liquid.
Yeah, so we've got like a double wishbone suspension system in here. So, you know, this cylinder will actually pivot and lift. So the actual bottom of the boat will be about to the top of the tire there. So you have a lot of ground clearance. If you've got a steep bank, you know, you can really drop the tire and get that approach angle so that you can, you know, give it that boost to get it out. So,
good. Yeah. And it also can raise and lower. It can go up.
Right now, this is as low as it actually goes. And then, the whole machine can raise to the bottom of it, to about the top of that tire. So.
How big of a pond, generally, will this be used on?
Guys were using them, like lagoons were getting bigger and bigger, and that's kind of why the trend went to agitation boats. But now people are seeing these things are extremely efficient at agitating even smaller lagoons. you know, when you're looking at the amount of volume and how easy it is to maneuver around, you don't have to reposition your lagoon pump. So you don't have that downtime from moving pumps. You don't have the money tied up in a tractor to operate that pump. And another great feature about it is, yeah, you can get around all over this lagoon. So, you know, like an average lagoon, which might not be that big, even if it took 8 hours to mix, this thing might take half an hour. Mm-hmm. So when you're burning 6.5 gallons of diesel an hour and it's only taking you half an hour to do a job, then there's some huge savings there. Another huge savings come in is for guys that use sand bedding. A lot of people say if there's 100 cows, it's going to cost $10,000 to remove sand for 100 cows. And that's just kind of a rule of thumb figure people use. When these things go in there and they can eliminate that bill, it makes it quite an attractive machine.
So you can move all the sand through this pumping system without
worrying
about
abrasion. Yeah, you can get all that
sand
and suspension. And, you know, if guys are like drag lining, they say like, oh, we got to put more boosters in because of the amount of sand we're pumping through and how thick it starts getting. So it's amazing how much sand it really can move.